trying to capture the essence of these old buildings here, especially those on the left, the timber frame buildings. I'm in St Foy la Grande in southwest France, and trying to do this scene justice. This is the, I guess, the main square in town. There's the main town hall. I'm gonna paint this scene here. Quite a nice shadow going across that building that's facing us, a sort of 45 degree shadow. Excuse the noise of cars coming around the scene. Maybe people as well. So, medieval buildings in St Foy la Grande. Let's get started. Just a little bit about the materials I'm using. It's I've got Saunders Woodford cold press watercolour paper, 15 inches by 11 inches. Paints are from handmade paints from Jackman's Art Materials in the UK. More information on that in the description of this video. First of all, do the outline drawing, which is very important. Now, there is this tree in the middle. I'm not sure whether to include that or not. I'll probably exclude that, and I'll have the bunting that's going across the street. We'll pop that in its place. So we've got number of, I guess it's three dwellings on the left-hand side, and there's a tantalizing little gap of sky in there. We've got the buildings facing us way up there, and there's a raised bit, another little bit of roof, and then down, and it just continues over the other side. Now, trying to get in these little so I had to stop. There was a car coming dangerously close towards me. The perils of plein air painting. There are plenty of cars going around, so let's see if we can get in a car or two in the scene. Let's have one over here. Have it at a jaunty angle. There we are, car. Balcony on the far side, some arches. Some people as well. Now, figures. Trying to use a reference point. So the top of that car, for example, that might be roughly the same height as, say, a shoulder. Sun is coming from the right. So I just had to direct someone in on the right-hand side, as you may have come into the camera shot. Shadows on that background building. Let's see if I can get in another figure in here. And they're walking into the scene. Light's coming from the left-hand side, so these shadows are going to go a little bit that way. There's shadow on the foreground as well, with a tree above me, providing a little bit of shade here. The bunting across the street. Let's have some squares. Do a bit of painting. That should have been a square. Do a bit of careful painting around those. Chimney. There are a few lines going across the sky as well. I think that's about it. Let's just move that arch. That arch is right above the top of that car, which doesn't look particularly right. Let's just move it a little bit, move the car a little bit to the right. Let's get another vehicle in there. There we are. Drawing done. All right, let's lay down some paint then. First of all, with the sky. So a little bit of... Well, the sky, it's a very small part of the overall scene. So not too fussy. Slither of sky in there. Over that whole area and down to the rooftop on that side. Just paint a little bit around some of the bunting. Next. The rooftops. Not too dark because they're in the light. Then on the right-hand side, a bit of light red, burnt sienna. I've got a little bit of blue in there from the wash. And the wall, yellow ochre. Again, a little bit of careful painting around. and try and introduce a little bit of variation in the values on that wall. Maybe a little bit of coolness in there as well, just gray it down a bit. Around the cars. Down to the ground and there. Right, next. Bit of base colour on the buildings on the left. I like to paint around those again when I go in darker on the left. This is just to cover up that side. Just with something, a bit of burnt umber actually. Paint around these figures as well. Oops. Paint around the figures, so I'm not exactly sure what colour they're going to be. So I'll keep my options open. Right, down to the road itself, which is a warmer colour. But mix up a little bit of coolness in there. Now that's almost the first phase done. Yeah, first phase done. Covering in the most of the paper, first wash, except for those areas that are going to be painted in a particular way, handled in a particular way. Just lift out some of this street level here, just introduce a little bit of variation in some of the values in there. There we are, that's that one done. All right. Check this is dry. No, it's not. That's dry over there. Right, we could do a little bit of shadow work now. So ultramarine blue, burnt sienna, a little bit of neutral tint, and start with the chimney up there. And then the right-hand side of that extension. Left-hand side of the building facing us. Around the bunting again, there's a little sort of pointy shadow there, which is quite nice. Shadow under some of the balconies, windows. That right-hand building, the town hall. Just move my palette a bit further away from that car to the right-hand side. Okay, buildings on the left, and they are going to be burnt umber. And a little bit of ultramarine blue and yellow ochre. So three buildings, and then this little overhang. Around the bunting again. Now the edge of the building on the left hand side is quite dark, so go in with a little bit of neutral tint. And the building does get a little bit lighter towards the bottom. Tiny bit lighter. Now shadows across the street. Let's go cooler, bit of cobalt blue. I was going to go lighter with some pillars in there, but I think I'll just go keep it simple. These figures will have a little bit of a diagonal shadow across them. Warm it up a little bit with, or a cool red rather, alizarin crimson. Continue on with the shadows on the building facing us, and it's got a bit of an extended first floor, comes out just a little bit wider than the ground floor. Connect with the car. Some shadows in the foreground from the tree. Make it a little bit more solid in that bottom right-hand corner. Really dark with those archways. Forgot the shadow is hidden by the tree, but there's a bit of shadow there on that rooftop. Now back to the left hand building and some darker values underneath the underneath the roof there. This paint still, the surface is still a little bit damp, so I'm getting a soft edge. Right, just while it's drying a little bit, getting some detail on the cars. First of all, this car here. And these cars, get a windscreen on that one. Make this a little bit red. And then dark. Really dark underneath the cars. Perhaps a little bit of darkness under that car there. All right. Change of brush. Oh, a couple of brushes. I will have a small synthetic brush and a little flat brush. Little flat brush for the windows. Go. Ah, there's a little bit of shadow. Whoops, there's a little bit of shadow underneath the balcony. Should have done it at the same time as that one. It's all right, I'll dry a little bit lighter. Right, is this drying now? Nearly there. Right, first of all, get in some of the horizontal braces or timbers of these timber buildings on the left. And it doesn't need to be perfectly straight lines. Then some darker windows. There's three main ones here. And then two there. Some darker shadow. There's these pillars around the square here, and the supports for these pillars. There's obviously some very dark shadows behind those. This flat brush is quite good for doing thin lines, narrow lines as well. A bit of indication of the street level. Now for some of these timbers. Oh, I've got a cat. This is what it's all about, this video, these timber buildings. Figures. Try and get a sense of movement of these figures. But we're down to the detail stage now. Nearly there. Got the bunting to do. Love these figures coming towards us. Change my mind. Yeah, simply done. And let's do this bunting. So greens, yellows. Greens, yellows, yellow, green, red and blue. Choose some green first of all. Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And then a blue. And I should have a yellow or a red. Oh, let's do the two. Just clean that up a little bit. Yellow. And a red. Oops, a bit too dark. Water it down a bit. Maybe they're a little bit lighter because they've been scorched by the sun a bit. There we are. Bunting fluttering in the wind. I need a bit more detail on that building in the background. Just create the impression of the town hall on that right. It's a little bit of a slope of the car park. There's an archway there. archway here. These figures are too identical. Need to give them, or give one of them, slightly different clothing. So let's give this one a yellow ochre jacket. There we go. And maybe this one is carrying a bag. A bag or two. Right, rigger brush. Now I get in the final details of the bunting. Need some string supporting it. There are some other cables going across the road as well. Few little lines for the tiles. Balcony on that far building. Just a hint at some of the railings. Then few little lines for those supports of the building. Maybe a few little lines going up the street as well. Always helps lead our eye into the scene. Not too many. Let's get in a few more figures.
C'est beau, monsieur. Magnifique.
Get a little figure in here. Maybe walking. That way. Perhaps another figure in that gap in there of the corner of the square. Like that. And I need to work quickly because the sun, as you can see, the sun is coming around now, and that makes it exceedingly difficult to see what's going on. I generally always paint plein air in the shade. So let's just quickly finish this off. And then we're done. There we are, St Foy la Grande, trying to do justice to those lovely old medieval timber buildings. I think it went all right. Missed out the tree as a choice, as a composition choice. It was just obliterating. It's spring and the foliage, the canopy is not very dense at all. So you can sort of see through it, but then you can't. It just makes it a little bit more difficult to try and capture things. Well, imagine the tree's not there. But actually paying a little bit more attention to the bunting, cars, with all the background noise, you can hear all the cars going around the square, people as well. And these lovely timber buildings on the left-hand side. Thanks for watching.